Yes, class 9. So yesterday we were studying about the chapter in the kingdom of fools, right? So what we have read about it, that the guru, who with his magical vision he has seen that something wrong is happening with the disciple, and disciple, when he had no other way out, so in his heart he has remembered his guru, and the guru appeared on the scene. And what happened? He came to know what is happening to disciples. So suddenly what happened? He whispered something to his disciple, and then they started mock fighting. Mock fighting means they started fighting in front of the king, that I should be the one who would be punished at this stake. And the another one was saying, no, it should be me who should be punished here. Then afterwards, the king was surprised to see their mock fight. He has never seen nobody in his life who is ready to sacrifice his life, who is ready to die. So the king turned out to be inquisitive. He wanted to know that what is the reason, that why he wanted to die first. So the guru took him from the earshots of the other soldiers as well as the ballast present there. And ultimately, he has told him that this is a special stake which is called as stake of justice, god of justice. And it is fresh one also. Nobody was ever punished over this stake. So he told that whosoever is going to be punished here, whosoever is going to be executed here for the first time, he would be the next king of this kingdom, or he would be the next king in the next birth. Okay, or in the next life. And moreover, the king did not want to leave his kingship. He wanted to be the ruler forever. So he was a fool. So in order to be the king in the next life also, so let us see what he will do. So I am reading from page number 25, third last paragraph. The king was now thrown into deep thought. He didn't want to lose the kingdom to someone else in the next round of life. So now the king, he was turned into deep thought. Now what should I do? It means he thought that only in this life I'm the king, and in the next life who will be the king? So he never wanted to lose his kingship. He needed time. So what he thought that I needed some time to think upon this matter. Because I told you that this is a story based upon the theme of indecisiveness. Indecisiveness means making right decisions at the right time. The king was not able to make right decisions. So this is another example that he said, I needed some time. So he ordered the execution postponed to the next day and talked in secret with his minister. So there was nobody else than his minister with whom he should talk. So he had to consult his minister. It's not right for us to give over the kingdom to others in the next life. Let's go on the stake ourselves, and we will be reborn as king and minister again. Holy men do not tell lies, he said. And to it, the minister also agreed. So what? Finally, they have come to the conclusion after discussion. He said, see that he is a saint, or he is a holy man, and he will never tell a lie. I think that we should ourselves sacrifice our life, or we should ourselves be executed on the stake, so that when we will be dead, or in the next round of life, I will be the king again and you will be the minister. But the thing is that I have to be executed first and the next one you. So now the minister also agreed to this, who was of course a fool. So he told the executioners, we will send the criminals tonight. When the first man comes to you, put him to death first, then do the same to the second man. And those are my orders. Don't make any mistake. So they did not want to disclose it to people that why they wanted to be executed first. So in secret, they have told the men who were given the responsibility of execution, that is the executioners. So what he has told, the king told, so at night, two persons will come to you. whosoever will be the first person, execute him first. Then after some time, the second person will come and you have to execute the second person. So, who will be those persons? That would be the king as well as the minister. That night, the king and his minister went secretly to the prison, released the guru and the disciple, and disguised themselves. Disguise themselves means they have changed their attire. Okay, right? And as the two, and as arranged beforehand with loyal servants, were taken to the stake and promptly executed. Promptly means immediately, without any questioning and without any delay. So what happened now on that day and during the night, they have released the minister as well as, sorry, the guru as well as the disciple. Now king as well as the minister, they have disguised themselves as the guru and the disciple. So in the dark of night, nobody will be able to figure out who is the exact man, because faces are not clearly to be seen. And moreover, they have disguised themselves in the attire of the guru as well as the disciple. So what happened at night when they have gone, the loyal servants, they were ordered beforehand also that they, that whenever the first person will come, execute him immediately, and then the second person, and there should not be any kind of delay. So when the bodies were taken down to be thrown to crows and vultures, the people panicked. They saw before them the dead bodies of the king and the minister, and the city was in confusion. So see, finally they were executed. Now, in older times, what was the you can say ritual, that after execution, the dead bodies, they are thrown in open so that the vultures, crows can take the flesh out and only the skeleton will be left. So then afterwards, the dead bodies have to be thrown in open so that the vultures as well as the crows, they would feed upon them, and ultimately the skeleton would be left. And one of the men who was passing by through that place, he has noticed that it was his king as well as his minister. They were in confusion that what has happened and why they were executed. All night, they mourned and discussed the future of the kingdom. So, the wise men who thought that I should take the responsibility, they mourned. Mourned means they presented their sadness on the death of the king and the minister. But on the other side, they were also worried. Why they were worried? Because of the reason they were thinking that what will be the future of our kingdom? What will happen to the kingdom? Now, who will take the reins of rule? Some people suddenly thought of the guru and the disciple and caught up with them as they were preparing to leave town unnoticed. So some people, they thought, I think that the guru and the disciple who have come to our kingdom, they're wise enough. We should make them the king and the minister. So they were actually on the other side, while guru and the disciple, they were trying to leave that kingdom because they did not think that this was an appropriate place to live there. And they should not live there. So, we people need a king and a minister, said someone. Others agreed. They begged the guru and the disciple to be their king and their minister. So, they begged the guru and the disciple so that our kingdom actually needs a, needs a king as well as minister. As we don't have any wise man here, so I think that please you can serve us as the king as well as the minister. To this, what do you think? Who will agree first? The disciple. Actual nature did not change. Okay, he was of greedy nature. So naturally he would change. Agree to it immediately. Now, but guru knew that this is not possible. So it didn't take many arguments to persuade the disciple, but it took longer to persuade the guru. So to this, the disciple agreed after one or two pleadings, but the guru was not ready to be the king because he knew that it is not easy to be the king. And this is, of course, a kingdom of fools. They finally agreed to rule the kingdom of the foolish king and the silly minister, and on the condition that they could change all the old laws. So finally, what happened? They agreed to be the king as well as the minister after a number of requests, and finally the guru turned out to be the king, as well as the disciple turned out to be the minister, where once foolish king as well as the silly minister ruled. So from then on night would again be night and day would again be day. Okay, and you could get nothing for a do. It became like any other place. So finally, the rule of the day and the night, they were changed again. And moreover, it was also changed that nothing can be sold for one dudu. It would be like that of another, any other place, okay, where everything is sold or different things have different prices according to their weightage, right? So this is all for the chapter. So very interesting story. Do you like it? Interesting one. Till end, we are not able to come to know. So here, when you write down a story, so have you come over the element of suspense here? And the ending is in an unexpected manner. Okay, these are the main components of a story. Okay, so just remember that whenever you will write down a story, because short story is there. Okay, it's a long story, but short story you have to write down. And that you have to add an element of suspense, create suspense. First of all, the problem which the main characters are suffering, create suspense. Never let the audience to guess the results. Give the ending in an unexpected manner. This is what this is to. Okay, right? So that's it for the chapter. Now, coming up to discussion of the questions. So first of all, what are the two strange things the guru and his disciple find in the kingdom of fools? Okay, yes. Your name? Ramni. Okay, Ramni. Yes, of course, absolutely right. I'm missing Panika here. Panika, you can also come to school. She's also giving good answer. He's coming?
Yes, ma'am, I will come after some days. Actually, I was suffering from cold and that's why I'm avoiding to come.
Okay, right. Then afterwards, come to school, okay? Then you will have complete interaction, right? So the first answer is, what are the two strange things as Ramneek has told? That the two strange things that the guru and his disciple find in the kingdom of fools was that the days were changed into night and nights were changed into days. It means that all the businesses, including trade, farming, as well as taking care of the animals, they were carried on in the night. And whenever with the first ray of the sun, the people used to sleep in their houses. Okay. And another strange thing was that everything was sold for a dudu, whether it is a dozen of bananas or a kilo of rice. So everything, there is a same price for everything, that is one dudu. Okay. So next, why does the disciple decide to stay in the kingdom of food, and is it a good idea? Yes. It was not the right place. Okay, so the disciple decided to stay in the kingdom of fools because he was happier, he was pleased by the idea to avail all the things at a single price, that is one dudu. As he is fond of eating, he wanted to eat everything. Okay, so this is the reason. This is the reason he decided that this is the best place where he can have plenty of food to eat. But the guru who is full of wisdom or who has medical vision also, he knew that this is the kingdom of fools. And he knew that in this kingdom of fools, it is unpredictable for the kingdom of fools that what they can do to them. So this is the reason. So moreover, this chapter is also delivering the message that to tackle fools is also very difficult. Okay, so that king and the minister, they were fools, and it was difficult for the people to tackle them. They were giving silly orders, and ultimately people, just because of the fear of death, they were following those orders. Okay, next, name all the people who are tried in the king's court and give the reasons for their trial. Yes, Panika can give the answer. Yes, Panika. Panika, unmute yourself. Yes. I have unmuted you, Panika. I don't know why you are not able to unmute yourself. Okay, Arshpreet. Who's Arshpreet? You are Arshpreet. Your name? Lovelina. And yours? Nini, afterward. Astha, okay. Okay, then Arshpreet, yes, give the answer. Okay, sit down. Yes, Dia. Okay, bricklayer, after bricklayer, it came to
dancing girl.
After dancing girl,
goldsmith.
And finally, it came to the merchant from where the story has started. Okay, so what you will write down? So because the king was indecisive in nature, he was not able to make right decisions at the right time. So he has tried number of peoples in his court of justice. In order to be just as well as placid, so first of all, he has called the merchant whose wall it has been fallen down upon the burglar, and he has called that burglar as poor burglar. So the merchant has given the excuse. What excuse he had given? That it was not his fault, but it was the fault of the bricklayer who has made the wrong wall. Finally, when the bricklayer was summoned to the court, he pleaded in front of the king, or he pleaded the king that it is not his fault, but actually it was the distraction that has been caused by the dancing girl. Okay, that has been caused by the dancing girl, okay, who was moving up and down the street, and she was distracting her. And finally, when this dancing girl, now who has changed into an old woman, and she came trembling to the court, and in her view, it was not her who was distracting the bricklayer, but it was the goldsmith who was making her move up and down the street. She was coming and going into the street because of the reason that she has ordered a pair of anklets to be made for her. And the goldsmith, as he was busy in delivering the order of a rich merchant, was calling him again and again. And when the goldsmith was called, he again came out with his point that it was not actually his fault. It was the merchant who has ordered some jewelry, and he has to deliver the order well in time. And finally, again from this again what happened that the crime has come turned out to be a complete round of circle. It has started from the merchant and finally it has come again to the merchant. Okay. Next one, who is the real culprit according to the king and why does he escape punishment? Who is the real culprit according to the king? Okay, Ashpreet. Let us listen, Panika. Yes, Panika, you can speak now.
Yes, ma'am. The merchant's dead father was held responsible for making the wool weak. But according to the king, rich merchant was the real culprit because he had inherited both sins and riches of his father.
Absolutely right.
So then he escaped the punishment because he was too thin to fit the stake.
Yes, absolutely right. So who is the real culprit? The king, with his great decision, has come to the conclusion that the actual culprit is the merchant only. Why he's the actual culprit? Because he has inherited his father's property, so do his sins. So he has to pay for the sins of his father as the wall it has been built in his father's time, but not by this merchant. So finally, what has happened? But luckily, he escaped the punishment. Why? Because when the stake was built, the minister suddenly noticed that the merchant is too thin to fit this stake. So finally, they were looking for a man fat enough who would fit the stake. So this is how the rich merchant, he escaped the punishment because it was only the foolishness of the king that has saved him. Next one. What are the guru's words of wisdom and when does the disciple remember them? Yes, what are the guru's words? Okay, Lina. Yes, of course, right? So, the guru who is full of wisdom, magical powers also, magical vision also, and he knew that this is the kingdom of fools. He has warned his disciple also that he would not come to know what they would do to him, right? So, finally, what has happened? The guru's words of wisdom included an advice for the disciple that this is a kingdom of fools and he would never come to know what they would do to him. But the disciple did not listen to the advice of the guru as he was fascinated by the idea of availing all the things that is for just one guru. He was so happy fond of eating and he was so happy that everything is going to be just for one guru. Okay, so finally what happened? But when he was going to be executed for doing nothing, and he was just fat enough to fit the stake. So at that moment, the disciple, he remembered his guru's words that it is actually a kingdom of fools and they are so unpredictable in nature. Next one, how does the guru manage to save the disciple's life? Yes, Diya. So the guru, how guru? Guru who is full of wisdom and he knew when he has listened the prayer of his disciple who prayed who prayed to his guru in order to save his life. So then guru appeared on the scene and he whispered something in the ears or he whispered something to his disciples. And after that, what happened that or they started a mock plan. Actually the guru who was intelligent enough, he devised a plan. Okay, he has devised a plan, and in that mock fighting or the mock fighting between the guru as well as the disciple, it surprised the king. So what happened? What happened? So the king was surprised. So he wanted to know what is the reason of their fighting and why they are so interested to be executed on the stake, as everyone loves his or her life. So the guru took him from the earshots of the soldiers as well as the other courtiers and told him that this is a special stake which is called as the stake of justice, god of justice. And throughout in his life, whether he has gone to different you can say kingdoms, but he has never seen this kind of stake. This is a special stake which is called as god of justice, and whosoever is going to be executed first here will be the king, or will be reborn as king, and the whosoever will be executed at the second place will be the next minister of this kingdom. So the king as well as the minister, they did not want to leave their kingship, and finally decided, or they came upon the result that it is only king as well as the minister who will be executed there. And they disguised themselves as the guru and the disciple, and in the dark of the night they were executed. The king was executed first and then afterwards the minister. How the guru's wisdom saved the disciple's life, and he was saved finally in the end. Okay, so you have to write down these questions in your notebooks. Okay, write down all these questions in your notebooks, and if you have any doubts, you can ask me now. If you have any doubts? So,
ma'am, when we have view our notebooks,
you can start sending your notebooks. Okay, as much work you have, index properly made so that I can check and resend back to you. Okay. But don't get so eager, ma'am. I have sent today, you have not sent me today only. It's not possible. It will take time. Okay? Because if I will open up your notification, that means it is seen. Then whenever I open my device again, then I'm not able to remember that whosoever is sent. When I'm checking, I'm only opening the chat at that. Okay? It is just because of this reason you people think, ma'am, you have not seen my notebook. No. Whenever the notification is there, I acknowledge it at that very time. Okay?
Ma'am, we have to send you in the group or on your personal number?
Not in group, please. So in group, it is difficult to drag all the notebooks, right? One notebook, then another. I'm again cutting back in the group, then the other ones are lost. Okay? So kindly send my personal contact. Moreover, if you are sending it in the group, others can copy your completely your work. Okay? So this is all for the Kingdom of Fools. In the revision part, we will discuss many extra questions of the chapter also, right? So you have to write down in your notebooks. Okay, so any other doubt if you are having, you can ask me online as well as offline regarding the chapter. Yes, what? No, it doesn't matter. It was only like that they have not, that the stake was too, you can say, it was not, that the man was not fitting there. It was not like that. Yes. It was only a foolish act on that part. Right? So that's all for today. And in the next one, we will start with the writing skill. Okay, in the next class, right?